Hello everyone and welcome to Recipes You Like. In this video today we are making vegetable chop Calcutta style, which you also get in the railways. The filling is perfect, hot, spicy and sweet with a coating that is crisp but still melts in your mouth. So let's get cooking. For the veg chop we need a garam masala, that is garam masala. For this we will roast some spices. We have taken 2 red chilies, 1 big cardamom, that is black cardamom, 1 bay leaf, 1 inch of cinnamon stick, dozen of black peppercorns, 2 to 3 black cloves, 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds, sonf, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds, zira, and 1/2 teaspoon of coriander seeds, dhania. After adding all the whole spices in this pan, we will switch off the flame below and keep it over a low. Roast the spices over this low heat till your kitchen gets fragmented with the aroma of roasted spices, plus you will hear a crackling sound. Be careful not to over roast or burn the spices. After we are done, we will switch it off and let this cool down. Then putting it into the mixer grinder, we need to add some more ingredients in this. Goes in 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of black salt. Let's now grind it into a fine powder. This is done and looks absolutely perfect. Let's move on. Taking a tablespoon of oil, we will heat the oil, hereby dropping few cumin seeds, just testing the oil if it's perfectly hot or not. As this is a recipe from Calcutta, we will add to it Bengali mix of whole spices. So in this hot oil, we added panchfuran, which is a mix of 1/4 teaspoon each of mustard, cumin, fennel seeds, onion seeds and fenugreek seeds. After the whole spices crackle few seconds over a low, we will add to it 1 teaspoon of ginger paste and 1/2 teaspoon of green chili paste. Keeping low, saute ginger and chili just for 30 seconds and then immediately add over it. This is 1 big size shredded beetroot, and also add 1 cup of shredded carrot. Saute both together over a medium to high heat, stirring occasionally till tender or soft. In between, let's add here 1/2 teaspoon of salt, or you can add later on as per your taste, and 1 teaspoonful of sugar. Beetroot is a little bit hard fruit than the carrot. If it's not getting soft, you can add 1 cup of water and let it cook covered or uncovered till the water dries off and the beetroot gets soft. It took us about 10 to 12 minutes to cook this, and this beetroot carrot mix is soft. At this point, we will add 1 tablespoon of roasted peanuts in this and saute the peanuts in this carrot beetroot mix for about 5 minutes over a low to medium heat. To bind this veg mix, we will add to it 3 potatoes boiled and mashed. We'll combine the potatoes with the beetroot carrot mix. We will now add the remaining ingredients in this. Add 1 teaspoon of fresh coriander paste. If you have fresh coriander, add 1 tablespoon of finely chopped fresh coriander. That's hara dhania. 1 teaspoon of dry mango powder, amchur. 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder as per your taste. And lastly, the made garam masala,
which gives a very peculiar and strong taste to the filling.
Well, combine everything over a low heat and then just switch off your stove. We will let this veg mix to cool down till we are able to handle it. After this comes down to room temperature, let's shape out the chop. We will keep all of them ready in a plate. If the veg mix sticks too much to your hand, you can apply a little bit of water over your palm while shaping them out. Now we need to coat them. For the coating, we have taken here 3/4 cup of corn flour, that is corn starch. In this, we added a little bit less than 1/2 cup of water to make a slurry, which will be neither too thick nor too thin. You can check the consistency. Now we will coat this chop with the made corn starch slurry. And then coat it with the breadcrumb. Next, to give the chop a crispy thick coating, we will repeat the process. That's again coat the chop with the cornstarch slurry. And finally coat it again with the breadcrumb. We will do the process with all our chop pieces. Thank you.
keeping all of them ready for frying. Oil has been already kept to heat. In the hot oil, we will drop these veg chop pieces to fry. You can fry them over a medium heat, stir them, or that is flip them upside down after a little while to be evenly fried on all sides. And obviously, we will fry them till golden brownish in color. And after they are done, strain them out. When they are still hot, sprinkle a little bit of black salt over them to get that peculiar taste of a zingy vegetable chop that we buy from the local shop. They go best with a tomato sauce and a little bit of salad. Here you can see a perfect crispy texture and the coating not like a cardboard. Hope the recipe was easy to understand and you will definitely try it out. Before saying goodbye, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, hitting the bell icon till we meet again with another interesting recipe. Bye bye for now.